Myanmar, just 15 years ago. Limited electricity, limited phones, only two TV channels, and many children had to work instead of going to school, and so much poverty. Myanmar was North Korea. The country's leaders, military officers, lived lavish lives, selling off Myanmar's valuable resources to foreign countries. They hid from the public and built their own extravagant city far away from the Burmese people. A massive airport just for them, huge roads that were only for their cars. While the average family struggled to survive, the military leaders lived wonderful lives. Finally, a hero emerged, a woman in a male-dominated society. In 2016, Aung San Suu Kyi became state counselor, similar to the prime minister, and Myanmar seemed to change overnight. The country began to develop, new buildings were built, travel was opened up, and internet access for all. And most importantly, children started going back to school, and schools were being built in some of the most remote places in Myanmar. And Myanmar was ranked the fifth most developing country in the world. And here's where the story gets bad. The military missed their extravagant lives, so they decided to take over the country with guns. They claimed election fraud, which makes clearly no sense because the election wasn't even close. And in 1990, when the military ran the election themselves, they still lost by huge numbers. And even at that time, they refused to respect the election. The military shut down the internet. They've shut down the airport. They've caused panic buying of food and supplies and money withdrawals from ATMs. I visited Myanmar at the end of their 50-year military rule, and it was clear to see the poverty. And I visited just a year ago, and it felt like two different worlds. I couldn't believe the development that had happened in such a short time. The first time I visited, I could not believe how many children I saw being forced to work instead of being in school. This isn't about politics. This is about human rights. This kid, just because he was born in Myanmar, he should have the same opportunities I had. He should be able to study in school instead of being forced to work, so that someday he could become a doctor just like me. Help me let the world know about Myanmar.